today's topic, limits at infinity of rational functions. Example number one. Let us evaluate the limit of 7x minus 5 over 3x plus 8 as x approaches positive infinity. Let us try to apply the quotient law of limits. Find the limit of the numerator and then find the limit of the denominator. The numerator is a polynomial as well as the denominator. How to find the limits of polynomials is discussed in one of the videos in this channel. Please watch that video. This is the thumbnail of that video. So, in finding the limits of polynomials, we cancel all the terms in the polynomial except the leading term. So, we cancel negative 5 and then cancel positive 8. So, what we have in the numerator is the limit of 7x as x approaches positive infinity, and in the denominator, the limit of 3x as x approaches positive infinity. The limit of 7 as x approaches positive infinity is 7 because 7 is constant. The limit of x as x approaches positive infinity is positive infinity. The limit of 3 as x approaches positive infinity is 3. And the limit of x as x approaches positive infinity is positive infinity. 7 times positive infinity is positive infinity. And 3 times positive infinity is positive infinity. Positive infinity over positive infinity is indeterminate. We can avoid this indeterminate result. We can avoid getting an indeterminate result by dividing the numerator and the denominator by the highest power of x appearing in the denominator. So we divide each term in the numerator as well as each term in the denominator by x. So we have now the limit of 7x over x minus 5 over x and then over 3x over x plus 8 over x as x approaches positive infinity. This is equal to the limit of 7 minus 5 over x over 3 plus 8 over x as x approaches positive infinity. Next, find the limit of each term in the numerator as well as the limit of each term in the denominator. So we have the limit of 7 as x approaches positive infinity minus the limit of 5 over x as x approaches positive infinity over the limit of 3 as x approaches positive infinity plus the limit of 8 over x as x approaches positive infinity. In one of the videos in this channel, this is the thumbnail of that video, we learned that the limit of a constant is constant as x approaches positive infinity. And the limit of a constant over x as x approaches positive infinity is equal to 0. So we have 7 minus 0. This is also a constant, so the limit of 3 as x approaches positive infinity is 3. And the limit of 8 over x as x approaches positive infinity is equal to 0, so plus 0. 7 minus 0 is 7. 3 plus 0 is 3. So the answer is 7 over 3. Example number 2. The limit of 6x plus 7 over 4x squared minus 5 as x approaches negative infinity. Divide the numerator and the denominator by x squared. This is the highest power of x appearing in the denominator. So this is now equal to the limit of 6x over x squared plus 7 over x squared divided by 4x squared over x squared minus 5 over x squared as x approaches negative infinity. This is equal to the limit of 6 over x plus 7 over x squared divided by 4 minus 5 over x squared as x approaches negative infinity. This is now equal to the limit of 6 over x as x approaches negative infinity plus the limit of 7 over x squared as x approaches negative infinity divided by the limit of 4 as x approaches negative infinity minus the limit of 5 over x squared as x approaches negative infinity. This is now equal to 0 because the limit of 6 over x as x approaches negative infinity is 0 plus 0 because the limit of 7 over x squared as x approaches negative infinity is 0. And then 4. The limit of 4 as x approaches negative infinity is 4. And then minus 0 because the limit of 5 over x squared as x approaches negative infinity is 0. 0 plus 0 is 0. And then 4 minus 0 is 4. So we have 0 over 4. And 0 over 4 is equal to 0. So the answer is 0. Example number 3. The limit of 6x cubed plus 7x minus 6 divided by 3x squared plus x minus 5 as x approaches positive infinity. We divide the numerator and the denominator by x squared. This is the highest power of x in the denominator. So this is now equal to the limit of 6x cubed over x squared plus 7x over x squared minus 6 over x squared divided by 3x squared over x squared plus x over x squared minus 5 over x squared as x approaches positive infinity. This is now equal to the limit of 6x plus 7 over x minus 6 over x squared divided by 3 plus 1 over x minus 5 over x squared as x approaches positive infinity. This is now equal to the limit of 6x as x approaches positive infinity plus the limit of 7 over x as x approaches positive infinity minus the limit of 6 over x squared as x approaches positive infinity divided by the limit of 3 as x approaches positive infinity plus the limit of 1 over x as x approaches positive infinity minus the limit of 5 over x squared as x approaches positive infinity. This is now equal to positive infinity because the limit of 6x as x approaches positive infinity is positive infinity. Then plus 0 because the limit of 7 over x as x approaches positive infinity is 0. And then minus 0 because the limit of 6 over x squared as x approaches positive infinity is 0. And then the limit of 3 as x approaches positive infinity is 3 plus 0 because the limit of 1 over x as x approaches positive infinity is 0. And then minus 0 because the limit of 5 over x squared as x approaches positive infinity is 0. So we have now positive infinity over 3. And positive infinity over 3 is positive infinity. So the answer is positive infinity. Let us solve the same three rational functions using a short method. When the degree of the numerator is equal to the degree of the denominator. Number one, the limit of 7x minus 5 over 3x plus 8 as x approaches positive infinity. The leading term in the numerator is 7x. The exponent of x is understood to be 1, so the degree is 1. The leading term in the denominator is 3x. The exponent of x is understood to be 1, so the degree is 1. So the degree in the numerator is equal to the degree in the denominator. To find the limit, we just cancel all the terms other than the leading terms. So cancel negative 5, cancel positive 8. So this is now equal to the limit of 7x over 3x as x approaches positive infinity. This is now equal to the limit of 7 over 3 as x approaches positive infinity. This is equal to 7 over 3. When the degree of the numerator is less than the degree of the denominator. Number 2, the limit of 6x plus 7 over 4x squared minus 5 as x approaches negative infinity. The leading term in the numerator is 6x. The exponent of x is understood to be 1, so the degree is 1. The leading term in the denominator is 4x squared. The exponent of x is 2, so the degree is 2. The degree in the numerator is less than the degree in the denominator. We cancel all the terms other than the leading terms. So cancel positive 7, cancel negative 5. This is now equal to the limit of 6x over 4x squared as x approaches negative infinity. Simplify. This is now equal to the limit of 3 over 2x as x approaches negative infinity. The limit of 3 as x approaches negative infinity is 3. And the limit of 2x as x approaches negative infinity is negative infinity. 3 over negative infinity is equal to 0. Next, when the degree of the numerator is greater than the degree of the denominator. Number 3, the limit of 6x cubed plus 7x minus 6 over 3x squared plus x minus 5 as x approaches positive infinity. The leading term in the numerator is 6x cubed. The exponent of x is 3. So the degree is 3. The leading term in the denominator is 3x squared. The exponent of x is 2. So the degree is 2. So the degree of the numerator is greater than the degree of the denominator. To find the limit, cancel all the terms other than the leading terms. So cancel positive 7x, cancel negative 6, cancel x, cancel negative 5. This is now equal to the limit of 6x cubed over 3x squared as x approaches positive infinity. Simplify. This is now equal to the limit of 2x as x approaches positive infinity. The limit of 2 is 2 and the limit of x is positive infinity. 2 times positive infinity is positive infinity. Let us look at number 1. If the degree of the numerator is equal to the degree of the denominator, then the limit of the function is equal to the numerical coefficient of the leading term in the numerator divided by the numerical coefficient of the leading term in the denominator, whether x is approaching positive infinity or negative infinity. Now, if, for example, this is 5x and this is 2x, so the answer is 5 over 2. If this is 12x and this is 3x, then the answer is 12 over 3. 12 over 3 is equal to 4. If the degree of the numerator is less than the degree of the denominator, the limit of the function is always equal to 0, whether x is approaching positive infinity or negative infinity. If the degree of the numerator is greater than the degree of the denominator, the limit of the function will depend on the coefficient of x here. For instance, if x is approaching positive infinity and this is positive 2, then positive 2 times the positive infinity is positive infinity. If this is the negative 2, then negative 2 times positive infinity, then the answer is negative infinity. If x is approaching negative infinity and this is positive 2, positive 2 times negative infinity is negative infinity. If this is the negative 2 and x is approaching negative infinity, then negative 2 times negative infinity is equal to positive infinity.